Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in our Goldcrest Valley map and I'm peeking through the sunflower plants right now. Sitting right up in there. Just realized when we were doing this last episode, never really stopped to see how this worked. You know, a brand new header to the game or to the series, and I don't get a chance to see all the moving parts, but it is still that dreary, cloudy sky out there. Looks kind of ominous. It says it's going to be sunny next, so we should see this breaking up soon and turning to a bright yellow again. But let's pop in here and see how this works. That didn't work. Let's see. G and B. There we go. So I'll just drive forward a little bit and kind of see how the stalks drop into the between the spikes down there, and then go up the auger, and then the heads get kind of chewed up by the upper bar. I don't know what you want to call it. It's like there's rotating blades on it, and it just pulls it all in, pulverizes it, throws the rest out the back. There's all the stalks right there, and the seed dumping into there. We're done. Okay. So I think I'm going to run this one manually for the rest of this field. No point in paying the labor for such a small contribution. So we've got 9 miles an hour when we're running it, 6 miles an hour when it's hired out. And let's make sure I don't miss anything. Yeah, something like that. Wow, what a dirty windshield. So I need to get the cultivator going again. I need to decide what goes in this field. Got to look at the numbers and see what we're shortest on. Kind of want to top off. Did I miss something there? Mirrors. There are no mirrors that show back there. Yep, missed some. I'll stay out here. I can see what I'm doing. Anyway, I'm going to look at our total numbers and see if there's anything to top off so the next time there's a great demand, no matter what it is, we've got a good chunk of commodity to trade in and fill the bank account with. One more pass here. Grab that little bit over there as we drive it back to dump into the trailers. I don't think I can mess this one up, so we'll go back in cab. Otherwise, the other sunflower field is over there, and it's not far from being ready to harvest itself. That's surprising. In fact, I've got to see if we need to go fertilize that while we're doing the rest of this. We still have all the hay bales over there to deal with, or the straw bales. Don't really get the animation in this one of the sunflower seeds dropping in. Oh, yep, even I can mess this one up. Or, how do I word that better? I can even mess this one up. That's what I meant to say. All right, well, let's catch this one right here. And then we will turn off that guy and speed over to here. Speed at a whole 14 miles an hour. Get these last 4 or 5 plants and then go dump this guy off. Yep, we're happy. Don't know if I can get on that other side. I'm going to tip quite a bit. Kind of a hill. We'll come around from this side. And which trailer? Oh, that was closer than I thought. Well, it's just a lease. Alright, we'll dump it in here. Then I guess we'll go park this guy over by the next sunflower seed, sunflower field, and I'm ready for next time. Sit out. Well, the sun is coming back now. Let's see if it's going to rain. and it can be washed in the rain, but now no rain yet. Otherwise, he's all the way down there, so I have to come up with another excuse to work our way down there and turn him back on. Him or her. There's the straw bales. Let's leave this out here a little ways, just in case I do need to... Let's check right now if we need to fertilize that yet. So fertilized, yeah, we've got one more stage of fertilizer to do. Let's look at growth. He is in the final. Can't tell. Well, okay, yeah, there it is right there. Light, medium, and dark. I think I've still got time to do one more. All right, where's the WASD? There we go. Let's, this guy will work for the fertilizer. Let's drive over and get the cultivator going first, and then we'll... put the sprayer on the back. We'll do that. One of these days we need to get one of the dry fertilizer spreaders just to have a different way to do this. And then we've got to deal with this guy. Alright, hire him out. What's he going to do? Alright, he lifts it up. And he goes the right way. Okay. If I jump out now, I'll jump right into his path. I'll wait till he gets back in there. There we go. Alright, let's go spray that field. Yep, he's good. If I remember right, I filled up that sprayer just before we dumped it off. Trying to get rid of this last crate over here, and then it didn't... Yep, that wheelbarrow is right back in there. There is an elf that runs around at night and puts all the pieces back in the right place. Okay, I'm going to get in the cab so this roof doesn't drive me nuts. There we go. Oh, the other forward. Alright, and yeah, we're full. So I'm going to pop out of here. And at what point can I start opening up? Probably as soon as we get past the garages here, the carports. Well, that truck looks so small compared to this equipment. Now, theoretically, I can hire this thing out. Let's try it. Let's see what he does. Right about there. And hire. Definitely makes straighter lines. I'm just curious what he's going to do at the end. Now, there is room because this thing spans such a width. To just make a 180 and pull back in. Like you've got to actually extend the 180. It's too tight. So we'll see if he doesn't do a major routine of going out and backing up and a bunch of unnecessary stuff. See how smart the AI is here. Okay. And he turned it off. Well, he did a good job. Very precise and carefully calculated, and I'm impressed. Okay. Have fun with that. So what's left for us then? That's being done. Need to pick up the bales. I've already got 8 bales over at the pig shed, so we want to deliver 8 bales over to the cow pasture area. Let's move this guy. Just know what's going to happen. So we'll drop off 6 over there. And maybe sell the rest. We'll have other crops that have straw in them. So So we don't need to maintain it. And we've got 8 on here. So let's just haul that over there. I don't think there's a reason to have a stack of them over here. We'll never use them. The pigs use them, the cows use them, and really that's it. Other than just building up a stack for, just for appearance sake. Because every farm needs a stack of hay bales. But, I don't think there's any reason to tie up a shed with it. Well, so far this field is not replanted. So we'll give it a few more game days. Yeah, 2 more game days. Which is probably... Oh, we'll switch the speed back to 5 speed. Take it down right at the beginning of the episode so I can stare at it a while and figure out what on earth I'm going to do this time. But we're going to run it at 5 speed from here on out as much as possible. But at that speed, I'm getting 2 to 3 episodes a day. So 4 or 5 episodes from now. If these things have not replanted on their own, then I guess we'll take it upon ourselves to do a bunch of cultivating or plowing or whatever the next step is, as far as the computer is concerned. All right, where am I going? I want to say this would work. Got nobody in my blind spot. We'll just go for it. All right, looking down the mini-map, I think I want to take a right and continue through that intersection. I think that's where the encroachment is. Yeah, right up there. Whoops. Hit a curb back there. And the shed is right through here. Helper F has completed their task already. Great. Wait, which was F? I have 2 of them running. Alright, this is where we can store the straw. There or there? I'm thinking right in that corner. And I'm thinking I'm not going to do very well from in the cab, so let's just, what's the phrase I want? Stack the deck a little bit and get myself a running start here. Alright, those should lift it, right? No? I? Why? Why? I don't know, but that's what I want. Okay. Oops. That's not WASD. Where's my steering? There it is. Nice and slow in here. Right near... Yeah, something like that. What's it look like? Looks pretty good. Alright, so why did it? So why should release it? Hopefully it doesn't spring and bounce all over. Ah, we're good. Now, can I get out of there? I need to let the trailer go pretty straight because this bottom tines down there. I think we'll disrupt it. But we're good there, so why brings it down? And let's go pick up some more. Oh, that's right. I got that fork out there. Watch out for that. Should pull up on his own soon as, there we go, everything else resets. Alrighty, we're in town. I don't have a way to hold anything. There's no three-point hitch in the front, so there's no stopping off at a farm supplier to grab anything. So we'll just head straight back. Well, this episode should be coming out Christmas Eve, so I'm going to spend most of Christmas Eve working on a new series I'm bringing to the channel. A lot of you who watch this have seen the series on another channel, so you'll be familiar with it. probably be real excited about it. I'm going to have fun with it. But I've got to work on the... I'm going to take a shortcut here. Boom, boom. Work on the intro video maybe tonight. And put it all together again. Maybe put together a new banner for the channel that reflects the new game. I guess something I want to do long term is have like two or three, maybe four games running on a banner that reflects those games or something like that. Wage payments. Somebody's still running. I'm guessing the fertilizing was the fastest one to get done. Let's see. What do I want here? X or C or V or B? B. There's so many choices. All right. I want to grab... I don't know which one it was. Cultivator, I don't see either moving. Oh, not necessarily moving because, yeah, he's down there in that corner because that's just the top of the hour, so that's just reporting how many wages were paid that hour. Anyway, I want to hit from this orientation. The end of the barrel. Whoops. Oh, it still worked. Kind of fun. So this game is on sale right now in the Steam Christmas or winter sale. Oh, that's right. We gotta wait for that guy to get all the way to the front again. So have you ever thought about picking it up just to play with it? It's kind of like driving remote-controlled cars in a sense. Yeah, it's fun. There we go. One more. I think we're full. Think we're full. Oh, we are full. Okay, so B pulls that in. I know it's available on Xbox and probably the other platforms. So well, it's on several different platforms. So you don't have to get it for PC. You can run it with a controller. In fact, I think you can run this with a controller anyway, even on a PC. Lots of different ways to do it. Question is the cultivator done? I see red out there. I think they're all finished. Okay. Let's back this in from here. I don't know if there's enough room over there to turn it around. A trial and error here. Far to the left, go to the right. Far to the right, go to the left. That's my backup system. Yeah. Something like that. Y is a long stretch. There it is. And I think that's... Well, we can... back up a little to... Yeah, something like that. Y again... Any cells. So 246 per. Alright, why again? And while that's happening, let's talk about new seeds. We've got two fields. I would like to get some sweet potato? No, sugar beet. The other two word that starts with an S. Or potato going. I don't want to buy the equipment to do both planting and harvesting, though, so we might buy a field that does that, that has one of these in it. So we'll ignore this for now. I see. Now, Klaus was pointing something out. I looked at these, and I just assumed we have 47,641 sunflower seeds, or liter, or, you know, units. Turns out that is an L. That's a liter. We have one digit less. So we've got 29,000 liters of barley and 32,000 liters of wheat. So based on that, really corn is the next one. We don't have any way to harvest it. So I guess that one's not going to get done. This we're bringing in now. So I'm not sure what to put in. Huh. Don't have an answer for that yet. Well, let's do what we do know for now while I'm thinking about it. So that got done. Need to do those. Need to put equipment. Oh, he is still running over there. Okay, that answered that question. Does he fit through? I think he does. Squeeze through here. Yeah. Yeah, this part of the game is a lot of fun. I really enjoy driving the equipment around. There's no way I'm ever going to have a working farm in real life, so here's my opportunity to pretend that I do. Spend my afternoons, my evenings, doing something that's kind of fun. It's one of the things the computer allows you to do. The computerized gaming, so you can jump into almost any kind of world that you want to. Something you'd never be able to do in real life. That's why I like Skyrim. Boy, that feels so realistic over there. You let your imagination take over. Alright, we have got 8. Right? Yeah. And B brings that guy in. And this time, let's go ahead and try to back up from in the cab. Let's see how that goes. I have a feeling there'll be parts of it. Well, I can kind of look over the top of this guy. Completed their task over there. Great. Alright, so I have a feeling it will actually be easier from in here. I can react quicker. Because I'm like right there. Yeah, this is easier. Though it's hard when you've got a big trailer and you can't see over the top. And your mirrors really aren't angled where you'd need them to be. I mean, that doesn't tell me anything. It's just red. That helps a little bit, but anyway, and what I can't tell when I do this is depth. I'm guessing I'm right near those yellow lines right now. Actually, it was pretty close. So why does that look like from inside? Okay, everything slid down. Back up a little. I like the backup lights. And why? Boom. All right, we're 259,000. Why? Let's go grab one more load. Ah, we got this guy here. And B. B. There we go. And we've got our stump sitting there. Got to deal with that. So how many bales do we get out of here? We sold 2 loads and we dumped a load. So 24, 25, there's 26. 27? Looks like that's it. One little stock over here missed. Yeah, I think that's it. Nothing rolled this way. Okay, we'll leave those on and just go park this guy. Park this guy means go over here. Cultivator's done over there, so we can get him started over here. Though, let's do verify that we don't need to be plowing right now. Almost certain we've got one more run on these fields. This guy we'll toss into bay number 2. Now this is tricky, because again, it's a depth of field thing for me. I'm guessing that as you get used to it, it is no longer so difficult. I watch Dagger win, he just floors it in reverse and it lands perfect every time, and I'm thinking, how do you do that? See? Yeah, oh, let's see. I wouldn't have even noticed that. Pull that guy in. Let's continue. See if we can... Nope, not going to get him out of that. There we go. That's what I need. Perfect. All right, cue that one. And we're out of here. So, let's go down to the cultivator. Actually, let's look at the map. Growth, I want plowing. All right, so nothing needs plowing in here. Okay. Just noticing this. I did plow that one, and it claims that it still is. Even though this one, I did plow too, and it showed up as not. Interesting. Anyway. Okay, we don't need to do any plowing. And he finished at what end? Is he up there? There he is. I guess no matter what I'm doing, I'm going to end up sprinting back to a tractor somewhere. Oh, that's interesting. You're kind of finished. All right, well, let's... Let's just do this for a little while. Make sure everything is happy. Make sure everything is okey-donkey. Mrs. Rambler was on her phone trying to send a message and wanted to say okey-dokey, and it just kept auto-correcting her to okey-donkey. She could not get it to accept dokey. Okey-donkey. So it's kind of a little joke here in town, or in our house. I see took a signpost out there. So how did this edge go then? Everything looks happy over here. Everything looks okey-donkey. Let's get started at this corner over here. Something like that. Hire him out. Bail. And he's off. Okay. This guy is ready for next time. Let's... put him in position. I don't think it matters which side to start on, but the original tutorial started us down here, so let's just take that as a cue that this is what the game likes. All four making it work. Alright, you live there. Let's go frolicking through the sunflowers here. Whoa. Psychedelic, man. And let's grab the sprayer and put him away. Lights are on. Interesting. No, they're not. Alright, everything's happy here. Actually, it looked kind of funny. It's dark. Okay, it just looks gray. It doesn't look the right color brown. Huh, okay. Well, we're going to go with it anyway. X. There we go. Going to top him off, but I can see the possibility of someday grabbing a different sprayer or something and wishing I had a little bit available in there, so I'm going to leave him alone. This guy does what? He backs in at an angle. So, get inside here. Hello. Well, let's see what we can do here. I'm going to go down the center. I can't do that. I have no idea where I'm at. Okay. Down the center and then curve in. That's the idea. Right there. Clear of that? Yeah, that looks good right there. Cute. Drive out. Whoa! Oh, these ceilings. Okay. That's done. What's left up there? Got to get the grain hauled away. Okay, let's do that. Sunflower seed. And we're just dispersing tractors all over the place here. Alright, we're going to deal with this guy too. Let's do this. Alright, let's see how many sunflower seeds we've got. Well, we've got 17,500. It seems like there was 4,000 something in there, so we'll be coming in around the 20,000 mark. Plus, we have that field to deal. So, probably another 12,000 out of that one. So, we'll be a good 30,000 when we're done. Liters. And we'll thread the needle here and land right at our loading dock. So, which one is selected? The rear one is selected. So, G, and I think it's I. Yeah. Alright, so G and I. There we go. Alright, that's good. And it's good until the next field. So let's do something like this. Oh, that wasn't a cue. There we go. Here, I thought I was going to just pop that off there. Look at that. The, what do you call those things? Give me my camera back. Never mind. I can't get in there. I can't think of the term for those. Rhymes with socks. I can't think of what they are. Cab, what do we want to do here? I want to go that way. And I'm trying to get over to there. Yep. Just can't do this out of cab. Or in cab. There we go. Now we're in tree. Alright, if one right doesn't work, try the other right. There we go. Alright, let's see if I can find the cue. Ah, got it. Alright, what else gets put away? Is this a good tractor? No. Let's go find the big tractor. Put that on the new sower. Where is that thing? No, the good tractor is on the cultivator. Okay, so this is the next best one. Alright, let's go grab that new sower. I want to figure out something. Did it do sugar beets? I can't think of what the fourth symbol was. I don't think it did. Alright, so... why? Yeah. So we've got soy, we've got corn, and that's sugar beet. It will plant sugar beet. What does it cost to harvest sugar beet? Beet harvester. Potato and beet. I guess if I called them beets instead of sugar beets, that would take away all the confusion. When I have sugar beet, I think of sweet potato. Two words and S is the first letter. But if it's just beets and I trained myself to do that, I have a feeling we're harvesting this route rather than this route. Even that's $100,000. But that's a $500,000. What is this guy? Headers are attached to combine harvest. Oh, this guy has to be bought on top of that. It doesn't even come complete. All right. And we do have another something here. What are you? This machine can collect sugar beets from the ground. Okay, so you can dump this guy into a massive pile, and this will conveyor belt it in or something. So, for convenience, you can spend a whole, almost $1 million on your beet system. Okay, so this guy tops off. Yeah, tops everything. And then this guy, the wheels dig him up and toss him in. And hold 6,000 at a time, which isn't very much. And then where do we put them? For those of you who've never played this game before, actually, I'm just gonna hop out. In the 2013 version, and the 2015 version, I'm thinking specifically of Westbridge Hills, but also Sosnovka, both those maps, had a bay like this, at least the Westbridge Hills, that was closed off on three sides. And you just dump your potatoes right here in a big pile, and there was a conveyor belt in the back that conveyed it up and over. That, whoa, really? One does the chainsaw. What's two do? Two does the chainsaw. Do I own two chainsaws? Anyway, escape. P, shop. So you'd pick up these guys. And something like, oh, I don't know which one. I only have the four to choose from. Yeah, it was none of these, but something similar that would be sticking in the pile of potatoes and ramp out of the bay. So you'd bring your trailer up behind it. And as soon as you got into place, you would start dumping potatoes or beets into your trailer. So you'd use a bay like this as a place to store something like that. Where do we have that we can store something like that? Those are actually enclosed over there. That could be, well, I was going to say it could be beet and potato storage. And they did the same thing with wood chips too. But we could also do that at some other field entirely. You know, we bought 11. That's going to be grassed out. This group was a possibility. No, it was this group. 3 and 4. They're owned by the same person. So that could be a permanent potato and beet operation over there with storage in between to do something like that. That's a possibility. I'm just debating whether to plant them now, plant any of it now. Let's go back into planning again. If we want potato instead, potato harvesting, we can't plant potato. Okay. So we have to get another sower to even get us. So beets are all that we have as an option right now. And you know what I don't know? We can't store beets in there, right? I mean, it doesn't make sense that you can. How does the game know that you've got beets if it's not stored in something like a silo? I don't know what it would consider to be an official storage space. We have to do a little research on that one. Or any of you who have got the game, let me know. Can you dump on the ground and it automatically counts? In any pile anywhere on the map? Or are there certain places that it expects you to place them before it will count them? But I'm tempted to put, a great demand at spinnery for wool. For a brief time, the spinnery is ready to pay a considerable higher price for wool. The offer lasts for another 12 hours. Let's take a peek at that. Wool, they're paying $49.60 for wool right now. I'm guessing that we can take a partial pallet. That might be smart thing to do. Okay, I'm 40 minutes into this episode. Let's set some kind of a sower going, and then go ahead and deal with the wool. So, cultivating over there, we can get to sowing? Okay, here's what I'm going to do. We're going to take this guy. He's got enough fertilizer and seed to do the job. We're going to put in beets over here. Which field is bigger? 12 looks bigger. I've got no way to click on it and get any kind of a measurement, though, unfortunately. So, let's get this guy going over here. And we'll put in beets. And we'll figure out later how on earth we're going to get them back out and pay for it. And then I'm going to get oilseed radish going in another one. And we'll use that as a fertilizer crop. Let's hire this guy to do... Now that is definitely beets, right? The oilseed radish had two stems sticking up, so that is beets. Alright, let's hire this guy out. Am I close enough? I think so. Hire, eject. Alright, you're in there doing that. Let's... Good tractor over there. Yeah, we'll use the... what do you call it? The Malibu? What was the name of our telehandler? Marabou? Yeah, that one. Let's get the sower on this. We'll use that other one to transport the wool. And that guy we'll eventually get back to. So, oilseed radish. Over here. He said for grass, so why? That's that guy right there. Seed. Let's do the seed. Let's get inside. There we are. I'm going to keep pulling right out of the middle. I'm curious to see what happens when we finally empty one of these, which one it's going to be. Alright, let's get fertilizer in here. Fuel. That's right. I was going to look at the idea of a portable fuel tank, but we'll make that the focus of next episode. Alright, R this one. Oh, we didn't finish off the seed. Why is that? What happened over there? We pulled one out from underneath. Okay, tells me we're going to be toppling a pile over here soon. Oops. Let's try that one. Ah, much better. Okay, a little further. Am I hitting the R? No, I'm hitting the T. There we go. Now we're good. And... it's this way. We fit? I think we fit. It's only a little bit wider than the tractor. Okay. So he's all the way over there. We'll never catch him. Get this guy going right here. Well, seed radish, higher, and escape. There we are. So I need to get over to the other field. Let's go grab the pickup. Maybe by next episode we'll have sunshine again. Kind of a gray episode. Oh, this feels so low compared to the equipment we've been driving. Feel like I'm in a go-kart. I'm thinking it's a Marabou rather than a Malibu, but it may be neither of the two. Remember, it started with an M and it had three or four syllables. And it reminded me of a place. Marabou sounds like a place in Alaska, like caribou. And Malibu sounds like either California or Florida, someplace with a nice beach. We'll see which one it is. Maybe that'll help me jog my memory. Alright, where do we park this guy? We'll pull in over here. Where am I going? I'm going over there. So we'll pull in over here. Alright, what is it? It is a Manitou. It was neither of them. Okay. I need forks. So let's lift. Let's see. Lift is that one. That. Cleanliness. Yeah, we could use a topping off. Let's do that real quick. Alright, so we want to drop down, tilt that way. Zoom in a little bit. There we are. Looks pretty good. And the right is that one. Okay, boy, that turns so fast. Alright. Done with that. Let's lift up. Put the wheel into the trough. There we go. And tip you back down. Good. How are we doing over here anyway? Animals. We're 43% on wool. I don't know what that means. Wool. L. Oh, so that means we have 863 liters of wool. It's strange to think of something like that measured in liters, but it sure looks like that's what that's trying to tell me. Anyway, cleanliness, grass is still fine, and actually that's productivity. Cleanliness will, I guess the top of the hour it'll reset. Water's fine. Yeah, we're doing okay over here. Okay, so out of this, and let's back up this way. Set this guy over here. Alright. Down. New. Like so. It's amazing how the momentum works here. If I swing it down, it'll I won't do it now that I want to, but it'll come crashing to the ground and lift up the tractor. Anyway, Q. Oh, that's not the Q. There we go. Cue the next button over. There we go. Now that's actually the bale spike. I don't have a... Do I have a pallet fork for this? I wonder if the bale spike will do it. The bale spike for the front loader will, because it's about the right spacing, but this one's got three tines on it. So, I'm blanked out thinking about it sitting over there. I didn't actually pick it up. Let's see if this will fit. Otherwise, we've got to run back over. Alright. So, in the air. But it may not have the right script for it and say, I'm not touching that. Okay. There. Drop. Is there any chance that I can hit this guy just off center? I mean, just barely off center. So, more like that. Okay. It's going in. It seems to accept it. Hey, it worked. Okay, we're going to tilt you the rest of the way. And a new pallet should show up soon. And begin filling that one instead. Got 870 here. Now it's almost $5,000 per something. Is it obvious what that something is? Back to prices. 0 liters. I got no indication of what they're paying that much for. I'm going to guess per 1,000. It's certainly not per liter. So maybe per 1,000 liters, but it doesn't actually say that. There we go. This is a nice, comfortable cabin here. Whoa, let's not dump the pallet. Okay, we're off to the spinnery. Okay, we can see it down there in the mini-map. And I can't see a thing. There we go. So this is the road that's got the bridge. We'll cross the river here. Clear that way, not this way. There we go. Spinnery. So, 2 blocks down to the right, but I'm not sure where the entrance is. It may be prior to that. Almost hit him. Alright, that's the spinnery. I'm thinking it's over here. Yeah, there we go. And we'll see this from the outside. Yeah. Okay. Now, how do we recover? Tank is empty on helper H. Okay. Now, what's the chance that I can still interact with this? Get up here. Drive in. And snag it. I have a feeling the slightest bump and that's going to flip off. So I'm just going to take my time. So we've got $257,000. Interesting. All right, so 4,300 wool in wool. Okay, that's done. Let's go and refill the sower tank and probably call this one done. Okay, so you're going to go up in the air. You're going to... I'll see if I can do all this at once. We'll do something like that. Completed their task. I'm confused about that one. Oh, that's the cultivator. Okay. The back route is this road here. Can I sneak between cars? I can. Children, don't try this at home. And you are making a left in front of me. Yep, Klaus, you're right. They do it. So I guess we're going to park this one at the farm for a while. And we now know that we don't have to have a pallet fork. Even although we have to realize it's not very stable. But at least the game will allow them to interact with each other. Okay, that was certainly not the D. There we go. Alright. That's a cultivator. Where's a sower? Who died where? That's over in that field. Okay. New. What tank was empty? Why are you still going? Oh, I'm confused. Oh, we've got two sowers going. That's right. It's this guy. Okay. Well, let's just park him there and go sprinting out there. So this guy needs a refill. The other guy is going to need one too. Alright, so we are doing beets, and we've got as far as there. Tank is empty. So, no, we were in the air. And there's plenty of fertilizer. Got too many buttons on my mouse. Now, there's always the debate on where the seed went. Let me get close enough. See what doors open up. There we go. Now it's opening up here. Even though up here it's white, it's fertilizer. We're filling. It's just not going to show me what we're filling up. Okay. Anyway, out of here. Get this guy going again. Let's top off the other one, then we'll call the episode done. Let's see, let's run up this path over here. We back up a little and hit higher. What does he do on his own? Does he figure this out? Okay. He's aligned again. Didn't miss anything. Alright, that worked. No, we're off by one over there. I'm going to ride this to the end. I'm going to align him one space in when he turns around. Otherwise, we'll end up with a gap at the other end. Map. And right there. Not getting any sense of a little blue strip in here. We have something going on right there. Okay. So let's hire this one out. Unhire. And realign this one to make sure that we're going to catch that other end just right. Okay. And we're still beats. Yep. Okay. You do your thing. All right. This other one is going to be running out as well. Actually, let's catch that next time. Yeah, I think that's probably best. Let's call this one done here. This has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching. And I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.